It was a passion project for very long, and it killed me to give it up. I'm hot, you're not. I'm a superstar. I'm a superstar. You know, I was taken completely by surprise. I think Anu had an inkling that Mr. Narayanan was stepping down, and you know, even Shyam Babu was planning give up his post. I had no clue. So that meeting was a complete bolt out of nowhere, out of the blue for me. And at that time, actually, I don't think it even registered what had happened, that I'd been made chairperson. I mean, the fact that Mr. Benegal himself had recommended my name and wanted us to sort of continue in their footsteps was, you know, something that took me a while to register. I didn't actually completely absorb the enormity of what we'd undertaken until a little while later, because initially it was just like, okay, we can do this. But you know, that's when we sort of looked up at this mountain that we had to climb, and then I was a little more sort of chastened and a little more, I wouldn't say anxious, but a bit more wary of what I'd got myself into, by which time, of course, it was too late. And I think both of us, Anu and I, both had a sort of sense that, chalo, we'll somehow pull it off. I mean, how hard can it be? Which I think we were sort of underestimating the task. Yeah, so back then, I think I don't know how everybody else reacted to the news. I sort of was a bit worried about time and how I would give it enough time, because I knew that if we'd taken it on, we'd have to do something really great. But Anu really actually has been the backbone of this festival, and being festival director, she's sort of really taken the bull by the horns and gone for it, and literally taken us all with her. If she hadn't been around and she hadn't been so committed to Jiomami, I think a lot of us wouldn't have been able to do what we wanted to do, or you know, we would have felt much more compromised. But I think having Anu as festival director was the best thing that could happen to Jiomami, and really all credit goes to Anu. It is a bit tricky. I feel I'm still learning the art of time management. I don't think I'm quite on top of it. Up until recently, I was giving a lot of time to Film Bay as well. So I think the past couple of years almost has been other projects other than my own personal work. I think it's also given me a lot of pleasure, and I think I've grown immensely as a member of the filmmaking community. I feel really quite humbled that people look to me and trust me and, you know, kind of encourage me to do and take on all these roles. So it's been a good year. I mean, I have to say, I didn't know what to expect, and I didn't think it would turn out to be as, you know, well organized as it is. I think all of us have just been chewing our nails for the last couple of weeks, and we can't believe it's just 2 weeks away. I mean, the kind of panic and anxiety that we've gone through putting together the jury, you know, what will be the opening film, all these kind of discussions that we've had have finally all, you know, come to rest, and I think we are feeling confident now. I think my writing suffers a lot. I haven't really been able to write another film, and for me that's my big failing. That's what I most want to do and I have least been able to do. You know, it's a moot point, but Aamir is also who he is. I don't know, there'll be lots of fathers, I'm sure, who are a lot as involved with their kids as the mother is. But you know, when you have so much riding on you and you have so many passions in life, which he does, it is hard for him. And I think he now is actually giving a lot more time to Azad than he was when he was doing Satyamev Jayate, which was very, very emotionally intense, took a lot of his time. And of course, PK, Dhoom 3 were parallelly happening. So he was really in one of the busiest phases of his life. I think doing PK and Dhoom 3 parallelly was very, very hard for him. I mean, you had to literally switch between Bhojpuri and being like, you know, Sahir or the other character, you know, so he'd do two characters in film. I think it was quite a hard, yeah. So it's now, I think for Aamir, he's back to doing just Dangal. And I think he really enjoys that now, just being able to focus on his character. And whatever time's left over, he gives us. So we've spent quite a bit of time in Punjab with him, and Azad skipped school and been there. Azad has taken this kind of bizarre liking for wrestling and wants to wrestle every day when he comes home from school. He's ready to wrestle. So clearly the film has an audience in younger people. We feel assured that, okay, four-year-olds will be interested. Yeah, but I think for Aamir, it's now a phase when he can give more time to Azad. It was very hard. I mean, I still find it hard to talk about. You know, it was very hard. It was a passion project for very long, and I think finding that space was for me the coup. I was able to find a space that, you know, we could really design to be a center, not just for film watching, but for taking, you know, the experience and translating it into creating a kind of film watching culture through, you know, being able to use an archive or a library, through discussions, through children's engagement with film, I thought have been the ideal way to actually, you know, have an ongoing film festival, if I may call it that. You know, it's an ongoing engagement with a different kind of cinema every day. And that venue was just perfect. And I really worked hard on it for 3 years. We had beautiful designs. It was all very, very great architectural team that I worked with at Busride. So yeah, it killed me to give it up. I really felt in many ways that I had been robbed, because it was my project to begin with. I mean, the idea was mine. I found the space. I made the designs, and then I had to leave. You know, I had to quit it. You know, I don't know whether it's easy to work when you don't have a clear idea of either the money or the intentions of the people behind it. You know, you don't know whether the money is going to come, and on the other hand, you don't know whether they actually intend to do it. There's a certain opacity in the workings of bureaucracy and government, and I didn't know how to navigate that. And I think it just took too much of my energy, and at the end of it, I just had nothing to show for it. So I had all these plans, but I had no team, I had no budget, I had no one, you know, kind of with me taking decisions, making things happen. Nothing was actually going on. In fact, they had promised that it would open in December, and I had no idea how that was going to happen. So it was, for me, it was just the only thing I could do was to step back and say, you know, I really hope that they do it, because that space deserves a great center for cinema. And you know, NFTC has the lease for 30 years. So I really hope that they do something with it and they put it up, because whatever they do, it'll be a plus for us. So I just hope they do something. I definitely want to watch Deepan by Jaco Diar. I want to watch this Brazilian animation film called The Boy in the World, I think it is, which is supposed to be absolutely beautiful. I want to watch Blue by Derek Jarman, which I think is going to be so exciting. First time in India, and it's a difficult film to watch, but I hope people come out to watch it, because it really pushes the boundaries of what we consider cinema. I want to see Hu Xiaoshen's film. I think it's called The Mountain Man Moved the Mountain. Mountain Moves. I don't remember the title of that. And let's see. I would really like to watch the restored copy of Pyasa. And I want to see Nicha Nagar. And I want to see Hakikat. All Chetan Anand's films that I haven't seen. Agnes Varda. Actually, you know, the list is endless. There's lots and lots of great films. You know, we've been in talks with each other actually about what it should be for the longest time, and there were a lot of international titles that were vying to be the opening film. We were really keen that it be an Indian film. You know, Bina and Deepti, who handle the Indian section, have been watching films, but we didn't see Aligarh until quite recently actually, about a month ago, when actually the film was ready to screen, and everyone went to his office and watched it. We saw it actually in his editing room. So we were lucky to see it and be able to invite it as the opening film, because it was a perfect opportunity to have, you know, to actually stand by our intention to promote and celebrate Indian films. There's no reason why an Indian film can't open the festival. And we have a great and awaited title. So a combination of good film as well as a film that, you know, people are looking forward to seeing and have heard of. So we really lucked out, and we're really proud to present Aligarh. Mine would be Half Ticket, because I think there's going to be some incredible films shown there, and I'm very interested in films for young people, and actually, according to me, that's the audience that I'm really most interested in. And the experimental film section will be the other. There are three things that I'm most excited about. One is the restored classics, Pyasa, the Apu trilogy, and Belladonna of Sadness, and Half Ticket and the experimental section, because the experimental section is the section that I pushed for. I mean, I decided that we should have experimental film. I literally, like, you know, held Anu ransom and said, movie mela nahi ho sakta jab tak experimental films nahi dikhaye. So they were very gracious. Actually, I was planning to do it as a 2-day kind of workshop thing in another place and not take up a main venue, but Smriti and Anu have very generously given us the main venues. I'm not sure which of the theatres it will be at, but it will be at one of the, we have the 3 PVR venues in Lower Parel and in 2 in Versova, and we have Regal, but it will be in a mainline venue. So so I'm really grateful about that, and that's the section that I really hope people turn out for. We've been doing it very carefully, obviously, because he also needs to lose the weight later. So he has to put it on in a way that it's not so unhealthy that he can't lose it. He's put it on very, very, you know, kind of scientifically, if I may say so, if it means, you know, he just has been able to, of course, eat a lot of things that he doesn't normally eat. So that's great for him. But now that he's put the weight on, he's back on a strict diet. He's monitored by a dietitian in the US, and he has health checks really frequently. I don't want to talk about this issue because there's a lot of, I don't know, there's a lot of conjecture. I don't want to add to it. I wasn't there. And I don't want to, I have not read about it. I have been in Punjab where luckily the Tribune does not give you this kind of news. So I heard about it through a friend of mine who told me that it was in the papers, and he called me to ask. But really, these are grown men. I'm sure whatever issues they have, they can sort out amongst themselves. And I don't think it's anything that I personally have any interest in talking about, to be honest. It's a, yeah, let's leave it at that. It's something that I'd rather not comment on. I'm hot, you're not, I'm awesome, best.